18 for one, two gone. Lovely shot, but well stopped in the covers, so just a single. It's quite close, I think. Cook just shakes his head rather quickly. That's what she's looking for.
I'll just pick up on what you were saying earlier, Athens, about...
She goes again over the leg side, definitely trying to bring the leg side into play by moving across the stumps, effectively so. Yeah, yeah, it was just, I think. Just coming out at long on this time.
Claire Taylor and Beth Morgan.
Sun's just gone down behind the trees now, so ground is cloaked in shadow. Nicely chipped. Yeah, with these boundaries that size, there should be plenty of opportunity. Firmly struck this time.
Yes, Pezza.
Just a single out into the deep. It's 55 for two.
Yeah, I think from England's point of view, 140 is probably about par. And
wasn't an easy catch, but she made ground in the end as Sarah Taylor plays that superbly, actually. The man out in the deep is way, way in front of square, so she gets across, uses the wrists and knocks it behind square, 65 for two. Quite a nice loop. Going on with the arm on this occasion, but a nice action. It wasn't a full toss, but it was made into a full toss by the good footwork from Sarah Taylor. Sweetly hit and into the gap. We'll run away for four. It's very nicely timed. That's probably the furthest part of the ground here at Chelmsford.
Yeah, lovely timing here from Sarah Taylor, dispatching that over mid-wicket.
Could be at least one. Could be two now. It is two.
Clipped beautifully on to the leg side. More good work in the deep. Shot, only bring one. Beautifully placed. Excellent use of the feet. More good work. My word, they have been really, really good. Very energetic. Not quite. Quite timed and doesn't quite carry. Who else would play? Aaron Brindle, is that another?
Perry against Taylor.
Brilliant shot, finds the field.
Heather Knight's already also done 3 years on the programme.
Lovely shot, not quite through. Decent hand. Lovely shot down the ground. Is it timed well enough? Not quite. Once two, Danny Wyatt is okay, so is Sarah Taylor. Gets lucky, and I think we'll go for 4-2. A little bit of improvisation, not when she intended, but it brings up a wonderful 50 for Sarah Taylor. 50 from just 37 balls. Really good running. Slightly unfortunate, of course, it always is when it rebounds off the stumps. Not a lot the fielding side could do. Now then, will this fall safe? No, yes, just.
Pace well on Sunday, so I suppose it's different with 2020.
Down, soggy.
Wicket looks good.
Has she found the boundary? No, she hasn't, I don't think. Lovely strike down the ground. Yes, just enough to go for four. That's the boundary England wanted.
The edge over several other batters.
That's clever too, but only one. Lovely looking shot. Further frustration.
Pushing on, 126 for two. That was well hit, but for none, and should be a run out. There is a run out. Natalie Siver, the new batsman. Now, is there glove there? Wide of extra cover. Placement has been a really outstanding feature of Sarah Taylor's batting today. Beautifully down the ground. Sometimes wonder whether you're effective hitting a full toss of that height with a cross bat, but another couple. The field here. Test England's fielding later. It's a drop catch, but very firmly hit back at the bowler. Goes leg side and long. That will take her to her best in 20 over cricket. As Siver sprints back for the second, that's good running. Boundary's hard to come by though. And that won't be one of them. They come back for two though, and they do.
Yeah.
Well. Last ball, the way to go, trying to heave the ball away over the leg side. It's bowled a little shorter and a little quicker, and it just scooted through. So 146 for four is England's score. Sarah Taylor going for 77, which is the highest score by an England player in this form of the game. So well played to her. It's a decent effort from the England women's team as well. They've made 146 for four. And we'll feel pretty confident of defending that target.